One love.
He can hear his fans are in the house.
One all.
Oh, the first time they really open up. And we saw the athleticism of Lin Sedong there.
Lin Sedong there, a bit vocal on the table. Seems to be very pumped for the match.
Yeah, and acknowledging that it's a bright start, this.
Four, one.
But Duda is a very, very good all-round player. He controls the table very well, so it might cause a bit of trouble for Lin Sedong.
No trouble there. Anything Duda throws at him, he hurls back.
I think that was a taste of what we're going to see. I mean, even Duda there stayed in the rally very well. But Lin Sedong there just had that extra control and consistency.
Just bringing the heat, and he just could not lift that over the net. He's coming back with interest.
1-6.
Shake of the head from the German there, and that's a point he did not need to be dropping.
Seven, one.
And suddenly it's seven, and suddenly he is staring at a huge deficit here against this bubbly young Chinese player.
Wow,
too good.
That was another level. So ferocious with that forehand. Putting everything into it. But mind you, that second time just went for placement over power. Very clever.
One, nine.
Well, you rightly spoke about the quality that Duda brings to this one, but he can do nothing in the face of this, because what's happened is that Lin Sedong has gone, right, okay, I'll just step it up a level and find the winners.
Yeah, so far, Lin Sedong isn't having really any issues.
Oh, surely not.
Oh,
he's won it!
What a shot. Round the net.
That's the best we've seen. Best we've seen so far.
You don't often see Lin Sedong being pushed away from the table. Wow.
And he took the shortcut. And he won the point. Turned defense into attack. That is simply stunning. And it's also given him 9 game points.
11-1. Last one.
Straight away, Lin Sedong in with that positive energy.
One all.
Turn our thoughts to Benedict Duda and what he does to try and stop this irrepressible, seemingly irrepressible player.
Two, one.
He just can't get a foothold in this match in any way.
Yeah, I mean, he's trying to play positively and aggressively. I think that's the right thing to do. Because if he's just too passive, then Lin will just power through him.
One, three.
Yeah, at the moment, Lin is inevitable. Get into a rally, trade shots, he's going to find a winner.
One, four.
And that's a rueful expression on the face of the German. who seems powerless at the moment against this youngster.
Let one fall. Five, one.
And that gap is just getting a little bit bigger there. 4 points behind. He really needs to do something now that's going to rustle Lin's feathers.
There was just a little glance up from his towel there from Duda, as if to say, is this kid for real?
Bet by one.
Nicely picked up there from Duda. Saw that the serve was coming long. And he took the opportunity to make that first opening attack. And again, that's what he needs to do here.
Two, six.
But it was only the 1 point, and then back we go to this position of dominance here. It's interesting, we saw Wang Hao looking on there at this young Chinese player and impassive. But it's hard not to be moved by him.
Two, seven.
Another one down the line, another winner.
Yeah, I think the gap was there. Lin could see it. Again, just going for placement. He didn't need to put any power through the ball there, just placing it well.
9-2.
And again, look at this. 81.8 on serve. Less than 10% on serve for Duda. This is one-sided in the extreme.
Let 9-2. Two, 10.
It's 10 and it's 8 game points, and it's a familiar situation and a depressing one for Benedict Duda, who is staring at a loss in this second game. Lin Shidong is in a hurry here in Macau today.
Let 2-10. One love.
Well, he's got to find a little bit of belief somewhere.
Only 3 points won so far.
One, all. One, two.
Another one missed there.
They're at a premium, these points. And he'll know, he doesn't need telling, you cannot miss these opportunities. They won't come along too often.
Yeah, he certainly has to take them.
Three, one.
Time out. Just looking ahead.
4-1.
And are we going to see a similar trend here with Lin getting a long run of points?
Every chance.
2-4.
Now that's a rarity in that he's missed on the forehand there. Can't really think of too many cases when that has happened.
No, we haven't seen that at all, really.
Credit then to Duda, who's used that little break to his advantage.
Five.
He wouldn't normally miss those.
He's taken 27 of the 32 points that have been played, Lin Shedong. That is commanding.
6-2.
And there's another one for 6-2. And this is one of those cases of don't blink or you'll miss it, because he is flying through this one.
Seven, two.
Yeah, as we've been moving through this match, the rallies seem to have got a lot shorter.
2-8.
And you just feel that the confidence and the belief has drained out of Benedict Duda. Of course, he's going to give his best as a professional out here, but there seems to be nothing he can do to make any impact on this brilliant young player.
3-8.
Now, there was a bit of talk that he'd suffered a knee injury in Mendoza and has had to just baby it along and rest it for the last 8 weeks. I don't know if we've seen enough to suggest that an impairment to his mobility is responsible for this, but could have been a factor, could be in the back of his mind going into this.
Yeah, I mean, of course, that's something that can niggle away in your mind.
Nine,
and not give you the confidence that you would normally have when you're fit and well.
He could have the best knees in the world, and I'd probably venture that he might not have made too much of an impact on Lin Shedong, given the form that he has shown in this one here. But as it is, let's focus on the young Chinese player who's got a chance now to serve this one out.
10-3.
And there's one of them, and that takes him now to match points, 7 of them, and you would not go against him. And there it is.
11-3.
That is a demolition.